Hello and welcome, I'm Falek and today we are going to be wiping the floor with aliens.
Hello, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of XCOM Longer Impossible. Today we are going to South Africa, into Durban to stop a light alien abduction, so I'm taking my lower leveled troops so that they can get some combat experience under their belt and but it still doesn't mean it's gonna be easy though. We are still going to face probably an insurmountable amount of enemies, but we have to win. Because if we don't get experience on a light alien abduction, then when?
We're heading to South Africa for this one, and we need to get down there fast. Alien activity continues to surge within several major cities. Our response is crucial to minimizing the spread of panic.
Okay, so off we go. What are we going to do? Well, I see the Melody's on the rooftop, so I would want to go there. I don't know if it is visible, depending on our starting position. The Melody is not important, though. If we can get it, we can get it, but I see there are two canisters, one on the roof and one in the far starting location.
Strike team is Reese the AO. Requesting authorization to deploy.
Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike one is cleared to engage.
And that means tough luck, no meld for us. What are we going to do instead is, I am going to A, check my flank. But I'm going to do it with Mauritz. I do not want to see any aliens in the area where I am deploying, right? Okay, seems safe. So, we are moving in. We are going to be using the building as a staging ground for our troops. We are going to be getting in basically, and we are going to then try to fight the enemies in the car park when we can suppress them and deal with them easier. At least that's the, you know, general plan. We will see how it goes. And since the cutscene has shown me that all the men is too far away for me to even dream about reaching, I'm not going to give a single flying fuck. One is, for example, right there on the rooftop. See? Right there. Can you imagine? So yeah, obviously we are not getting any meld in this mission. Thank you, XCOM. Instead, we are going to get in pos... Well, fuck. I did not see that coming, but... that may actually be very good for me. Where is... there you are, my friend. There is Poseidon with an alien grenade. And he knows what to do. And... boom. Their cover should be bust. I hope all three of them are going to be uncovered, but... that happened. Fuck yeah. What I'm going to do? I will... well, quite frankly, I am going to just do my best to disable them. We can have holo target the pod leader.
Adjusting aim.
We are not going to disable them like that. I wish we would, but I am sorry, but I suddenly don't see that happening. So what are we doing? 77, 77, 87, but 87 is going to take two shots. I'm going to at least make sure that... really?
Blanco fallado.
Are you shitting me, game? The hell? So, we blew it. We blew it severely. We can't get them all, and we had a perfect opportunity to destroy them. Totally. But it is lost. Well, fine. Mauritz is gonna have to hit him in the open. It missed, also. I can't deal with this. This is just too much bullshit for one person to bear. Come on, Dr. Owens. That's not even a crit. It's fine. Yeah, we just gotta kill them, otherwise we are dead.
Solid copy, Commander.
Because they are in the open, but come on, how many shots can you miss?
Got him.
Okay, we made it. But, dude! What the hell, that was a simple destruction. There, even the grenade went out of its reach to be badass and awesome, but come on! So many missed shots, I can't even.
Double time.
Well, as they say, all's well that ends well. However, sometimes it's very, very, very annoying. And now we are getting prepped. And the meld on the rooftop is so annoying for me. I want it so much. But oh well. So what I gotta do is gotta stay away from the transparent door, because that's my doom 9 times out of 10. I just think to myself, yeah, it's gonna be cool if we just, you know, dash and get in position. And then shit happens. Alrighty then, we hear some enemies are in fact in the car park. Which is very good. The meld. Okay, we can get Maurizio in position in one turn. We can get Poseidon where he needs to be right the hell now. Zuriel goes there, Lanius get prepped. I'm going to move people to the transparent door, but not before I have everything and everybody ready. Because I just have lost so many missions that I know that this is what we would do. We would not risk activating the enemy by just moving in position where they can see me. So we are going to take it a little slower, but perhaps a little more effective. And Dr. Owens is going to steady weapon. Congratulations on your first kill in the game, by the way, Dr. Owens. Okay, now we move Maurycy. And we activate 2 sectors. And this is where you see good preparation rewarding for me. We can actually see the meld not being where it was shown in the cutscene. What? I can't throw a grenade through an open door? I'm gonna open the second wing and hope that it helps. Because... actually no, fuck it. Come on, Poseidon, don't waste a grenade on those bitches. So you survive. And Lanius is going to run and gun now. Shoot one in the face, grab the meld next turn, that's actually pretty nice. One down, one to go. And Maurizio has a 9% shot, but we do have a pistol, so let's make it a little better. 29, the important thing is a holo target. This is what we want from that shot. And Zuriel is going to deliver. It's a 47, but it's a good 47. I hope it's gonna work. What the hell? What was I thinking? Well, quite frankly, it is still okay. The sectoid is as good as dead. We are tossing in a flashbang grenade. Unfortunately, it will survive, but we lost all the meld anyway, so... I mean the rooftop meld. We can get the other one. And excuse me again for a second. Okay, I'm back. We can get that bastard, but it's a very tricky shot and it failed. But it's okay, it's flashbang, it won't go anywhere, it won't do anything. So I can just set Digital Dude on Overwatch, because that's what Digital Dude does best. And we are grabbing meld next turn, so everything is fine over here. It's gonna run away and get shot by either one Overwatch or the other. Come on, come on, Digital. That's right. Poink. And meld on the roof is dead. But there are two more that we want to get. Alien object inside. Got the goods. Boom, 15. and we can get another one, but it requires being a fast person. So what are we doing in the meantime? I want to give Lanius as much leeway as I can, so I will be sending Maurice to protect his rear with a marksman rifle. And be right back. Okay, I'm back again. So this is... we sense a strange disturbance in the baby force. But let's get this done and then we can deal with the different things. I'm setting up as many overwatches as I can, dashing the rockets so that I can use them the 2 turns from now with a steadied weapon. And I'm going to... I don't actually have to reload, I was gonna say that I will, but I don't need to. What I need to is to grab a lot of the meld. We can't hear any enemies right now.
Yes, Commander.
This is a very safe approach for it.
Got the goods.
Boom! 30 meld in one mission. Be right back. Okay, I'm sorry for those technical difficulties. There is nothing I can do about that, as you can possibly imagine. What okay. We need to do is to ready Dr. Owens' gun rather than the rocket, because we can't really trust a specialist rocketeer rocket even with a steady weapon, so when possible I will be using a rifle.
Come get some.
And it is time to narrow down. I'm actually using a pistol on the yes, marksman, sir. My bad. Yeah, it is time to get a read on where our remaining enemies are. We are relatively safe in our car park bunker, but this isn't going to last forever. Okay, now I know.
Quiet. Do you hear something?
Okay, so I know they are somewhere in this corner. What am I going to do? I'm going to get to those doors, get everything prepped. I am going to use an alien grenade to open a leeway for myself. So I will be using this as an opening. Meaning I have to get Umbok over here so that we can suppress safely. And. I actually cannot figure out the end. Yeah, let's get the medic over there. Not heal wound, you don't have any wound, you bastard. We are going to steady Dr. Owens' weapon so that we can use the shredder or the normal rocket when applicable. I guess I'm gonna reload the shotgun and the marksman rifle comes home with the rest of us. But this time I will remember to change Maurice's weapon back to his rifle. And steady it in case it's something flying. Also on Poseidon. Because I don't really think there is going to be something walking into me right now, I can afford a steady weapon. Actually, I think it was a little overkill on Poseidon. Since, you know, boom. Anyone home? I saw them in here, haven't I? There are seekers. So the fact that there are seekers in here makes me think of something devious. But it would require moving around and losing the steadied weapon. However, it would be so cool. Actually, that would also be freaking dangerous. I'm gonna keep steadying the weapon. I'm going to get the on overwatches everywhere.
Watching and waiting.
And I'm gonna overwatch one rifle. So they are behind that wall. I can use another alien grenade to make it work for me. I'm going to blow it because we saw them there, so we know where they are. What we need to do is to get a safe enough alien grenade. This should be good.
Frag out.
There you go, hello! Oh, the car's on fire. so everybody moves out of the away from the car.
They're moving to flank me.
So yeah, looks like my idea might work against me if I don't have a battle scanner right now. Tell me I have a battle scanner.
Position confirmed.
I know it's somewhere there, so I gotta drop the battle scanner, reveal that seeker and destroy it before the car explodes because it's my cover. I did not think this through, have I? Come on, digital. And it is so artistically done. I'm gonna holo target it just in case. It doesn't matter if you stay by the car or not, because if it doesn't end the mission, then we have casualties suddenly.
Excellent work.
Hey,
all objectives complete.
That shit's on fire, yo. But anyway, we are getting home before it explodes. We got 30 meld, not even a scratch on us, but it was a little hairy. I was absolutely sure that if I throw that alien grenade on the rooftop, then the car won't be in the area of effect, but it was. So that's something for the future. HE grenade will not blow up a car, alien grenade will.
By the efforts of our troops, Commander. Recovering this meld substance is crucial to our scientific pursuits.
Yeah, fuck yeah, it is, and we've done well. Okay, we have a bullet wizard build for a Yeti Umbok. It's a South African Yeti. So for a bullet wizard, I'm going to go with a shredder ammo rather than heat ammo. It's going to be more useful for me in the long run. We can heat ammo is normally the go-to perk, but it's been nerfed to only 50%, and that means I can shred it with Danger Zone, and that's gonna be awesome. And we have 31 meld out of that mission. And 80 cash. And we managed to broke a laser rifle and the auto laser. But it's not gonna cost us much. So what's happening? We have 4 days until council report. I want to get one more shot at this Exalt, but this isn't going to work, unfortunately.
Commander, our satellite is prepped and standing by for launch. We are ready to deploy it on your orders.
Yeah. Let's hope there is something more happening still. 2 engineers for meld. Nope. No, it's my meld. My precious. Hey, column! Column! Anyway, 2 more days and we are sending out
aircraft
our satellites.
Complete.
Okay, aircraft transfer is complete, so let's launch them. United States, boom, 118. Canada, 64. Mexico, 57. Air superiority is ours. Muhohohoho. China, we don't want it to leave the council. Boom. India, we don't want it to leave the council. We are losing the two countries anyway, but... it is the best I could think of. We have fought for France very hard and with a very much effort for a very long time, but we finally lost it. We are going to retake it and liberate France once and for all once more. And as for Brazil, well, we fucked it up. So that's
it. At least
it.
We've got some vets on our side. It takes a serious pair to go face to face with one of those things.
Yes, I know. We have 4 laser cannons ready for production. ASA fucking P. We might actually make it without selling anything. But no. Okay, fine. Why would I think that we can get it without selling anything? What can I... Can't I count suddenly? The hell is wrong with me? I'm sorry, I just got overly excited. We will sell some cyberdisc. No, we won't sell some cyberdisc racks, we will need them later, but we need the laser cannons now, so this is a little haggle that I have to do every time I want to sell something. I need it later, more important than, I need it now. Actually, it's going to be very hard to get cyberdisc racks soon, so... Let's only sell those that we absolutely have to. 4 laser cannons. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can count. In 9 days we have the air superiority that we want. And we may also want to get ourselves new fighters, but right now we're good. What I need? We also need a lot of money. But for what? 300 for penetrator weapons. And 400 for avionics, and we can't sell flight computers. So, what's more important, need it now or need it later? Well, you guessed it. Since we need 700 money, I'm going to sell everything that is not immediately essential. Like Seeker Rex, very important later. Not so hard to come by, and that means it's off the table. Flight computers stay. And the melt can go. We are going to take the 300 right now. And see if we are going to get enough for both. Actually, armored fighters I don't care about, but improved avionics are going to take 3 flight computers. Where is the penetrator weapons? There it is. You've got to be shitting me. So guess who's a moron? Well, I guess we'll just get that 120 and finish that foundry project right now. Yay! So I was saying to myself, when you start making the foundry projects, make sure that you leave yourselves that, you know, 3 cyber disk racks so that you can get improved avionics, because without it, the penetrator weapons, I mean, because without it you will suck. But, oh well. Well, oh well, we have 40 meld, 200 weapon fragments. I'm going to leave the flight computers. I only left myself one cyber dick rack. I am not a smart man. Well, let's get something for our people. Let's get the avionics so that we can hit them better. And I'm going to also need enhanced lasers next month, so we are in huge need to get the 150.
I'll make sure to notify you as soon as production is finished.
Pop, we have 160, that's enough, and that means we just sold all the meld we got from this mission, but that's good, it means we are going to develop better lasers. Yeah, Shen, we are keeping the boys down in the foundry very busy.